You know, when it comes right down to it, I'm not even sure busting makes me feel good anymore. Woo! Let's do this! I'm back. It is I. Old school. First name old, last name school. And I just got out of seeing Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. Now, I know this video is coming up a little bit late and half the world's already seen this movie, dude. So why would you watch a review at this point? I'm sorry. I thought I was going to go last night being Thursday, right, to see this. But as you can probably tell by my super pasty, terrible complexion and the fact that I might have a tissue in my hand for half this goddamn review, I've been sick for like a month, dude. Like, this thing will not go anywhere, dude. Kind of like reboot, nostalgia, bullshit movies seem like they ain't going nowhere, man. These motherfucking things are a part of life now. Legacy. Ooh. We're going to bring in some, like, super boring younger characters into every franchise that we love, and then, like, cameo sprinkle in the actors from the film that we originally saw that we liked that spawned said legacy sequels. So I get a little passionate here. Maybe I should, like, say real quick, man, that I do these reviews for fun. If you're a new person, if you're an old person, you know. You know what I mean? Like, you get the drill. You know what I mean? I just like doing them because I love movies, man. And people have always enjoyed them. We're going on 9 years since that first Pixels review back in 2015 that I did for fun. So let's get into it. Mixed bag. Woo! You thought I was just going to hate it, right? You thought it was going to be hatred out the gate. Because I kind of got like, when people do watch reviews, they're like, oh, he's just an angry review. Angry. Oh, why are you so angry? Why are you hating? Well, you know, like I already said, very passionate, dude. Ghostbusters Frozen Empire is going to be a very hard movie to review, man. It's a mixed bag. A mixed bag movie that has both good things and bad things in it. It's genuinely hard to, like, you know, give a very, like, entertaining and funny review. Because if it sucks outright, man, you can make metaphors and just talk all types of trash or whatever. And if it's great, you can overdo how great it is. Frozen Empire, man, it definitely sucks. It's definitely not a good movie. I should say real quick, I hated Afterlife. I'm the dude, you can watch my Afterlife review on Old School Presents, my YouTube channel, unless you're already on the channel watching this, in which case, just scroll back and watch that one. Hated it, not a fan. Because it wasn't funny. It didn't feel Ghostbuster-y, and it was cheap. Very cheap. Now, this movie doesn't seem quite as cheap. It has more of a Ghostbuster feel. So, let me just run this on the goods and the bad. It's the only way to how to review this movie, man. We have good and we got bad, right? That's the good stuff first, man. So, you all know the drill, dude, right? We got these new motherfucking people, right? We got Paul Rudd, we got Stranger Things kid, and we got that little girl who's like fake 11, like, I don't know her name at all. And we got this super boring, like, Egon's, like, daughter thing, right? So we got these new characters, right? But then we got the legacy characters, you know what I mean? We got, like, Dan Aykroyd and, like, you know, Ernie Hudson and Bill Murray and stuff like that. Come together in this movie, dude, to basically try and advance the franchise with some new ideas. And one of the biggest things in this movie, dude, oh, I should watch the spoilers here, but one of the biggest things about this movie, and one of the greatest things that I think this movie has to offer, is actually finally talking about what it's like to be a ghost. Why didn't you cross over? Why are you not on the other side? You know what I mean? Like, what happened to trap you between levels of existence? You know what I mean? Like, why, where, you know what I mean? It doesn't touch on the God thing really at all, but definitely touches on, you know, how this happens, why this happens, which is fantastic. We've never got that idea from a Ghostbusters movie, and we also get the idea of haunted objects in this movie. We get a lot of, like, fantastic starts to ideas and what could have been a much more interesting story than a giant horned Diablo looking frost demon who just, like, freezes shit. He's only really in the movie for like 10 minutes toward the end. I mean, this whole movie's most interesting part is like the last 10 minutes, dude. I'll get ahead of myself. Let's go back. Go back, right? So, on the good tip, man, this movie has some fantastic new ideas to to offer to the Ghostbusters franchise. Problem is, they don't follow them through, they don't flesh them out, and they don't finish it. I liked the fact that when Bill Murray was on screen for his whopping 6 minutes of screen time, because really it's Dan Aykroyd the whole time. Dan Aykroyd's the main legacy character that you get the whole movie. That shouldn't be a spoiler. Bill Murray's here for 6 minutes. He's funny every time. He's funny every time. And there is a couple, because like my main problem with Afterlife was it wasn't funny at all. It just wasn't funny. You know what I mean? There was no jokes. Whereas at least this one has some funny jokes, man. One, if you saw the movie, you know what I mean? There's the whole, like, you know, smoke shop joke, which I don't want to ruin for people or whatever. That was actually funny, dude. Oh, yeah. This movie's so bizarre, right? Just jump into one of the negatives, man. How many characters did this movie need, right? So you got that Indian dude, I don't know his name, from, like, he was in, like, Eternals and, like, Comedy Central, like, all the time and stuff like that. He's a firebender. Like, a straight-up Avatar firebender in this movie. Didn't need that character. There's so much this movie did not need. I mean, Let's just jump to the negatives, because really the only positives I had were the couple things that they abandoned, which were good ideas, and Bill Murray. That's it. That's the good stuff. Bad stuff. It's pretty bad, guys. I mean, like, the only thing I can say about the nostalgia stuff is they could have made it worse. We could have got even more classic characters saying lines and stuff that rehashes and calls back to the original. There's a ton of it. There's a ton of it. But there's not as much as I think other people are saying that there is, man. You know what I mean? Like, it's definitely less overall, dude. But what this movie suffers from the most is one of the things that modern movies do not know what to do. I can speak English language. With these legacy movies. How many hacking characters can you put into one movie? So we got Firebender Dude. We got, like, Paul Rudd and his family, dude. And then we got all the Ghostbusters, including Janine, right? There's like 13 people in this movie, dude. And a lot of them have dick to do. Like, Mike from Stranger Things and shit like that. Wolf's Guards, Wolf's Bane, whatever the fuck his name is. You know, Stranger Things kid, right? Nothing. Nothing to do with this movie. They gave him a scene with Slimer that's... Two scenes with Slimer that are about, like, completely... Like, why? Why? It's like, why are the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man mini dudes in this movie again? Like, he just wants to sell toys. Now, we know that. You be selling some toys, that's why some of this shit's happening in this movie, dude. A lot of the ghosts execute-y and stuff like that. I mean, you could just see it was for the action figures. Another thing I hated, dude. I don't know. It's like, I was so ready to hate this movie, and there was about 10 minutes where I was ready to love it, dude. And all I can say is, dude, is it's better than Afterlife. I get that people love Afterlife. You really only love it because that Harold Ramis ghost shit at the end. Don't lie to yourself. That's why you love it, dude. But, I mean, outside of that, like, I really hate Afterlife. I hate Afterlife. This movie's better than Afterlife. I'm gonna go ahead and give it... I'm gonna give it 2 stars. I'm gonna give it 2 stars and say, you know what I mean? Don't wait for streaming. Definitely go see in the theater. It does make a big difference, man. Some of the special effects are pretty cool. You know, hearing some of the music, I mean, like, they kind of abandoned the original soundtrack, like the old 84 soundtrack. They used it a lot in the beginning of the movie. They kind of ditched out. But to hear and see what we loved about Ghostbusters in a kind of newer way, which I think Afterlife also missed on, works for Frozen Empire. So you definitely want to go see it in the theater if you're a Ghostbusters fan. All I can say is manage your expectations, dude. And this is why I've been pretty long. So I'm going to cut it right here, man. Thanks for dealing with me, dude. We're getting my pasta ass, my albinoness here. So my name is Old School. Talk to you soon, man. Oh, yeah, I'll talk to you next week. Godzilla. X-Kong. Godzilla X-Kong. Whatever the fuck that movie's called. New Empire, Frozen Empire. Everything's empires and stuff like that. So, anyway, dude. Deuce.